If you purpose to serve the Lord, expect the enemy to attack. And expect the attack to be primarily in the areas of discouragement and doubt. Expect it to be a psychological attack. It's going to be a mental warfare kind of a thing. The spiritual attack is going to be waged in your mind. That's where it's going to be waged. That's where the attack is going to come. And so when we read over this and we go, they laughed at them. Oh no, poor Nehemiah. Somebody laughed at you. This is way more than that. This is discouragement. This is doubt. This is pointing out the ridiculousness of Nehemiah's task. I mean, these guys could have been saying things like, Nehemiah, hey, how many construction projects have you led, bro? Holding all those cups. You got a lot of experience building walls, don't you? Right? And Nehemiah could have easily just crumbled under that and said, you're right. I'm so dumb. What am I doing here? Why did I do this? Why did I think I should do this stuff? But no. Instead, he holds to the things of the Lord, knowing that the enemy is pressing the attack. The enemy's not happy about you serving the Lord and the things of God. And we've got to know that when the enemy presses the attack, that we've got to defend with the boldness of the Lord. You see, discouragement and doubt is so powerful that it can stop God's work before it ever starts. Before anything ever comes about, before any rocks are moved, before any rubble is cleared, before any of this work ever takes place, the whole thing can get destroyed. The whole thing can come unhinged through doubt and discouragement. You see, the tactic of the enemy is to get your focus off of your God and onto you. That's what the enemy's going to try to do. And so long as you're thinking about you and your ability or your inability and your capacity or whatever, then your focus is wrong.